Shimo la Tewa School. Established in 1932, this is the only public boys' boarding secondary school in Mombasa. It is also the only national boys' school in the county. Since its inception, over 14,000 students have passed through the gates of this school. Some of the prominent alumni include former cabinet ministers Sharif Nasir, Katana Ngala, Chirao Makwere, Kazungu Kambi, Amukoa Anangwe, Paul Sang, and Franklin Bett. Others are former and current legislators like Speaker Francis Ole Kaparo, Majority Leader Amos Kimunya, and MPs Hatib Mwashetani and Lucas Maitha. Retired General Samson Mwathethe, Ambassador John Mwangemi, and the current Board of Management Chairman Mr. Sami Athumani Kivatsi are also old boys of the school. In its early years, Shimo la Tewa reputed itself as the academic giant of Coast Region. However, somewhere in between, the fortunes of the school began to dwindle. Performance in KCSE hit an embarrassing rock bottom, and the school became infamous for indiscipline.
Currently, I'm the longest serving teacher, so I know very many things about this school. Yeah, there is a time the school was doing very poorly because of attendance, because of the care of the students we used to take. Yeah, because of the character of the students, so parents would refuse to bring their students to school. And therefore, because the school has to keep running, the school will take anybody. So the performance went very low. It became extremely bad.
Things back then were difficult. And as you have seen, our school has no wall parameter. And this tells that the students were somehow indisciplined. And of course, I want to believe that performance and discipline go hand in hand.
The thing that struck me most was that the boys were all over the place. They were not disciplined. The dressing was horrible, slippers, folded trousers, open shirts. And I was told that was it. That's how everybody was used to. That's what everybody was used to.
Students could not be contained in class. Students could not come to you when you call them. They would just go away. They would even sneer at you.
We had so many cases of drug and substance abuse. Then there was also the issue of truancy was a bit high.
The norm was every other term there would be a strike.
During those days, of course, the compound was bushy, especially the boarding area.
Nashukuru kwa pia nilisomea shule hii. Na pia wakati wa mwanzo tunasoma hapa kulikuwa kuna mambo ya security.
Hii shule kidogo ilikuwa ina migomo mingi. Watoto kugoma, watoto kupigana, watoto kuchoma, naona kuvuta bangi.
Shimo la Tewa became a sleeping academic giant, an injured lion, a shell of its old self. Things only began to improve during the previous administration under Chief Principal Joseph Mwadime and the current administration under Chief Principal Matthew Mbinda Mutiso.
When Mr. Mwadime came, the changes started coming in slowly. He started insisting on proper uniform, including ties. He started insisting on shoes. And the teachers really supported him. We supported him fully in implementing all the changes that he wanted. And as far as academic discipline was concerned, and as far as dressing was concerned, punctuality, you know, all of it. And then he left. He definitely left a much better school than he found, by far, including performance.
Then the current principal took over, Dr. Mr. Madime, and he bettered what he found. He bettered by far the things that he found. And I give him a lot of credit in as far as the physical facilities of the school are concerned. Because his first concern was there must be something we can do about the school. It does not look like a national school. It doesn't give the picture of a compound and buildings that are well taken care of. So his first task was to give a fresh coat of paint to all the buildings, then the planting of flowers started, then the pathways, then the communities, a complete overhaul of the school. When he was done with that, he went on to the academic discipline. And he saw many things like subject planning, so the assistance in conveyor marking, things like that.
With the change of principles and time, things have changed.
I think the greater achievement that we have is the fact that you'll be able to change the students' culture. Culture change, and call it the biggest achievement that we can achieve. Because the mindset of our students currently is very different from what we had back in 2013, 2014. And that's why it is much easier to handle the students as it can.
The mindset of our learners has really changed a lot. Because the moment they love the school, when they are coming from the dorm, morning hours, they run. Even when they are going, changing classes, either from class to laboratory, they are always running. And to me, that's how an ideal school in this 21st century should be, whereby everything is done with the element of being cautious of time.
In the 4 years that Mr. Mutiso has been principal, the sleeping giant has awakened and the lion
because of the peace and stability that we have, our school managed to wake up. I can say wake up from the sleep. In fact, when I read some of the newspapers, they termed it as a lion that has started roaring because of the discipline. So discipline, I can say, is a key to performance. So most parents nowadays appreciate this school, and they can trust that whenever they bring students here, students are able to perform because of the hard work and the leadership of the principal. So behind the mighty Shimo la Tewa, as we call it now, it has had a long history, and it has been a very long journey, a very long, difficult journey for Mr. Mutiso to make sure that this school reaches the national standards of other schools.
When we took over the school, it was quite, without pulling a brag, it was quite not very conducive environment to work with for the students to study in. However, with the help of the new, the chief principal who came in like 3 years ago, a lot has happened. We have beautified the school. The first strategy was to make sure that we beautify the school and make the environment as much motivational.
So the boys actually took it positively, and we managed to achieve a lot in terms of discipline, in terms of respect for items and public facilities. And then now other things came in.
Performance in KCSE has risen steadily, with several students getting direct entry into the university.
Sasa shule hii ni miongoni mwa shule bora katika taifa letu la Kenya. Katika miaka hivi karibuni tumekuwa tukifanikiwa kupeleka watoto katika vyuo vikuu mbalimbali nchini. Asilimia kubwa watoto wetu wamekuwa kienda vyuo vikuu.
My name is Uga Miombo. Nimesomea Shimo la Tewa School, class of 2020, for 4M. Nimeweza kupata aggregate points of 75, ambayo ni A minor, na nimepostiwa kusomea course ya walimu katika chuo kikuu cha Kenyatta University.
Mimi Anderson Muta Harrison, ni kwa Shimo la Tewa class of 2020. Nipata A minus ya 80 points na sasa inafanya mechanical engineering in Kenyatta University main campus.
Mimi naitwa Swale Alex George, nilikuwa Shimo la Tewa mwaka 2020 from 4 East na semester 1, na I managed to score an A plus of 81 points na hiyo limewezesha kupata nafasi ya Shimo School of Medicine Kenyatta University main campus.
Commendably, Swale Alex Joy was the only student from a public school who scored a mean grade of A in the entire coast region.
So I was very excited. I was happy when I heard that I scored an A, and I was the only candidate from a public national school with an A. I mean, not only in Mombasa, but across the entire coast region.
Alex Joy and his classmates have fond memories of their school and are full of praise and appreciation to their teachers for making them who they are today.
My teacher and who was my father at school, Mr. Mungo. Mr. Mungo Danda was a very funny teacher. But apart from your funniness, you know it's like here. Because when I get a lesson in chemistry is hard. Even though I'm here and I'm here, lakini sasa anakuamsha saa 10. Na hiyo saa 10 anakuamsha anakuambia wewe umeamka saa 10 na anakuambia usilale. Kitu anakufanya usilale anakufanyisha practical saa 10. So ukianza kulala umevutabika. That's your happy day. So tena inabidi sasa unakuwa very attentive. So hiyo imetusaidia sana. Na pia kuna mwalimu mwingine ambaye anaweza kukumbuka my mother's mother. Watu walikuwa na mwogo. Tuseme wanamwogopa. Ninyi anaonekana, lakini she's a very humble madam. She used to help me. So mwalimu yote na mtu ona pale kuna shida. Lakini sasa au funny teachers tulikuwa nao na wametusaidia sana kupita. Nene kina Mr. Liu. Na kuna walimu wengine ambao anakaafanya yani anakuambia wewe ndio cheo ulipata hapa. Mr. Paul sai. Anakuletea PS yule. Sasa usiende na kuletea nini? Ni umesoma siku nzima. So nataka urelax. Ukirudi tena sasa after supper unaenda na kuja tena unasoma. So kuna elimu mbovu wana some funny lakini wako na kitu wanajaribu kumeka.
Nakumbusha the moment pale tulipokuwa tunaangalia TV kwa class yetu from 4 north. Yale at the time sisi tumeingia class tusome but tumeikuwa kamufu kidogo and then tunaanza kusimi with Mr. Said. Hakuna kia ni kutatuka kwa kope na kufusha mati. So nakuta ameandika mati pale kwa honi wana kufunga mati huko nyo. Anakuita mbele, anapata alamu kosa. Hiyo ni kibao ama ukimasikia. Hiyo ni kwa tu mfanyo, fanyo tu njani. Unakumbuka madam moto, awa madam, my history. Madam, alikuwa ni kufusha history. Unaingia class, ulalala, ukilala na kwa mshu ndoka hulu. Ukirudi tena, anakuangalia kama umeoka moja huko na kwa tena for the second time. So unakuita hulu kwa tu mfanya, lakini alikuwa na kusaidia kwa za nashidaika kwa tu attentive pale class.
Auma, Mr. Mungo, Mr. Liu, and the rest. I think for me, all teachers deserve a special mention. Now, I want to mentor, I want to shape out and push up. Now, for that, we celebrate them.
Discipline has also improved tremendously.
Shule yetu ya Shimo la Tewa imetoka katika sehemu ya shida in terms of indiscipline. Kuna wakati shule hii ilikuwa ikifanya vizuri sana katika masomo, lakini hapo katikati miaka ya nyuma kidogo ikaja ikawa shule ambayo haifanyi vizuri kwa sababu cases of indiscipline zilikuwa nyingi sana. So bodi ya shule na wazazi tukawa tunasimama kama kitu kimoja kuhakikisha kwamba shule hii inaanza mwanzo kuwa na mwanzo mpya in terms of discipline cases. Na tukajaribu sana kuondoa mambo mengi ambao wanafunzi wamekuwa wakipitana nayo kama the drugs ambayo ziko sana katika Coast Province, na tukajaribu kuongea na wazazi so that it has to be something ambayo wazazi wanajua, the community understand, na tukapigana na hii vice. Mpaka sasa hivi kusema kweli shule iko vizuri, watoto wametulia, na tunahakika kabisa shule hii itaendelea kufanya vizuri zaidi.
Kufikia sasa matunzo ya hapa ya watoto ni mazuri. Shauri wakati kwa hakuna security huwa ni kubaya sana. Na improvement imekuwa kwa because hakuna mambo ya kwenda nje ovyo ovyo. Na pia hata kama unaingia ndani si mambo ya kujua ati unaingia tu ovyo ovyo na kutoka ovyo ovyo, pana. Kuna records ambazo tumeziweka katika kila mlango.
Cases involving drug abuse, truancy, fighting, clandestine gangs and youth radicalization, which are rampant problems among the youth at the coast, have reduced significantly.
Wakati wakiingia wanakutana na security kwanza. Inspection lazima wafanyiwe kuanzia bagi mpaka kiatu. Na mpaka sehemu ya suruale hizi ambazo kuna baadhi ya vitu tunaangalia. Collars pia tunaziangalia, shauri mtoto za kumuona yuko complete lakini katika nguo zake amebeba. Kwa hivyo hizo vitu tumekabiliana navyo sana. Na pia tushapata baadhi ya watoto ambao wengine nao sasa hii hawako hapa. Because tukishapata mtu kama huyo tunampresent kwa authority ya shule. Alafu wanaangalia vile wanadeal na yeye. So tunajaribu kama sisi security kuona tunawaweka pamoja na kuona kwamba wana heshimiana bila kupigana, na mambo ya bullying hakuna. Lakini zamani bullying ilikuwa ni nyingi.
Shimo la Tewa has become a school again.
It's so calm nowadays as compared to the time when it took over the board and probably the previous regime before took over the board.
Sasa hivi watoto wametulia, na watoto hakuna kule kuchoma, hakuna kubuko bangu, gomea chakula. Watoto wametulia, wanasoma vizuri.
Student population has skyrocketed, with the Form 1 class now having 9 streams.
We can see with the even the intake, Form 1 intake, we can see how the parents are willing to bring their sons here. And therefore, the school is actually going back to where it was, the mighty Shimo. And I believe before I get another transfer, this school will be the very mighty Shimo that was at around 1980s.
Katika maendeleo ya shule hii tumekuwa tukipata wanafunzi kutoka katika jamii mbalimbali katika taifa zima la Kenya. Tumepata wanafunzi ambao wametoka katika shule za msingi wenye alama nzuri, hasa katika mwaka huu wa 2021 kutokana na matokeo ambayo tumeyatoa ya mwaka 2020. Kwa hivyo alama ambazo wanafunzi wanaingia nazo ni nzuri. Kwa mfano kuna wanafunzi wa alama 400, 402, 380 na zaidi. Kwa hiyo wanafunzi ni wale ambao ni wazuri kwa ufupi, na tunatarajia kwamba watafanya vizuri katika masomo yao ya kidato cha 4 kuendelea.
The school is staffed with qualified and dedicated teachers who work closely with parents to achieve greater success.
Parents pia wamecheza role yao mzuri sana. The class representatives from the class level wameangalia pia na kuhakikisha kwamba the syllabus inafuatwa vizuri, and us as a board tumekuwa tunakaa tukihoji walimu na kuwauliza what are their projections in terms of academic. Sasa hivi umepata mini ya 6 or maybe mini ya 8, I mean 8 or 7. What are your projections in the coming years?
Infrastructure has also improved with the construction of new buildings and facilities.
In terms of infrastructure, we managed to build 8 new classrooms in a span of 3 years. We've completed a multi-purpose hall, which is inclusive of a kitchen, a dining hall, and a theater hall. We've built 3 new dormitories in a span of three years. What else? We've achieved a lot, and the school has grown from a student population of about of actually 800 to 900 students to the current population of 1,600 in a span of three years. And so that tells you something, that there was a need for improvement of infrastructure, expansion, and therefore our thoughts were cut towards making sure that the accommodation and tuition facilities are sufficient to be able to cater for this, in order to cater for the 100% transition.
As we speak, SOBA and some of the donors have come in, and the government also has come in to make sure we have enough dormitories that we are going to, when we are now accommodating our students and they are comfortable following the COVID-19 rules, we can manage to have such numbers, because we are still building dormitories around here.
In the Coast region, we are the only school, high school, which has the French Resource Center, which is in our school, and the students are really benefiting out of it. This French Resource Center is also helping other schools from the region.
Under Mr. Mutiso's leadership, the school has also excelled in co-curricular activities like drama, music, sports, and essay writing competition.
And I see us also going far in terms of co-curricular activities, because Mr. Mutiso, as our principal, is very passionate about co-curricular activities, and he supports them. So I see us really becoming the giants we were.
Well, in terms of co-curricular activities, as one of the co-patrons, Drama Club, the school has been doing well, exemplary well in the drama activities, because we've been able to go to the nationals 5-7 years in a row. Yeah, and in those 7 years, we've been a drama champion, the play category in Coast Region. What I can say about co-curricular activities, and particularly drama, it really helps the students to express themselves in class, even able to relate what happens outside the society and what happens in school. Because for instance, if you have a play, like last year we had a play that was dealing with a cancer, yeah, it will enable them to understand different stages of cancer and what happens when someone is diagnosed with cancer and what they're supposed to do. It used to be a deadly disease, but with diagnosis and first stage, someone can really get to know many things about it. And therefore, co-curricular activities not only sharpen students' communication skills in class, they're able to learn generally what is happening in the society. Yeah, to mention but a few.
This has nurtured the talents of the students and given them a sense of self-worth.
Principal, thank you for your support as the school band. We appreciate you. It has not been easy, but since you came, you've provided the instruments, you've provided support for us.
We play some cover songs, and sometimes we make original songs, like the school anthem, Shimo la Tewa School anthem. Yeah, it was from one of the teachers, and it was in an association with the band, school band. And we also play the national anthem and the East African anthem. Yeah. The school. So we also want to appreciate the principal. We also appreciate the principal because he's the one who bought the instruments, and also he's the one who brought the trainer. And he also supported us in many occasions.
Mimi ni mwanafunzi kutoka shule ya kitaifa Shimo la Tewa, na nashukuru sana ni kwa kuwa Mungu amenijalia kuwa hapa. Kiukweli shule imenifaa, ni mwaka wangu wa mwisho sasa hivi form 4, lakini namshukuru Mungu kwa sababu ile legacy pia tunaacha hapa ni kubwa, ni kiukweli. Ya, na ile support ambayo shule imenipatia mpaka leo watu wanaweza nicheki kwa TV. Yaani nashukuru sana, sio? Our principal amekuwa akinisupport sana. Kuna video kadhaa tumefanya shule, kasuku wote. Yani miki ukweli, I don't take it for granted. I appreciate, humbly appreciating our chief principal, Mr. Mutiso Mbinda Salusana, na walimu wengine wote ambao wamekuwa kinisupport wanyao mwezi wangu pale, Shimo la Tewa, Sauzi, wote, yani wote ambao wamekuwa kinisupport, mimi nasema asante.
Being a cosmopolitan school, Mr. Mutiso has also worked hard to promote ethnic and religious tolerance within the school.
Sisi katika shule hii ya Shimo la Tewa, tunaishi kama ndugu. Hatubaguani baina ya Waislamu na Wakristo. Hakuna chuki za kidini. Hususan kutoka principal mpya aje hapa, Mr. Majaz Mbinda Mutiso amejaribu sana kuleta uwiano baina ya Waislamu na Wakristo. Kiasi ambacho kwamba wakati alipokuja hapa aliweka maombi prayers day kabla hatuja tukifungua tu shule tunakuwa na prayers day. Na katika hizo prayers day anapatia nafasi viongozi wa Kiislamu na viongozi wa dini ya Kikristo. Naomba kwa pamoja kuombea shule na kuombea wazazi, wanafunzi na walimu wa shule kama hii. Hilo ni jambo ambalo kwamba kusema ule ukweli sijawahi liona katika shule yoyote ambapo kwamba nimewahi kufundisha. Na sijawahi kuona principal mwingine akileta program kama hiyo. Hii kuonyesha ni mtu anayeunga mkono uhuru wa kuabudu na uhuru wa hilafu za dini.
Shimo la Tewa is indeed a model institution when it comes to religious and ethnic cohesion and harmonious coexistence.
In the past, we were disunited. We were not united at all. But since the principal came, he has worked towards promoting unity and harmony among members of staff. That's why when a member is bereaved, it becomes an issue of the whole school. Whether you are support or tutorial staff, we all join hands to assist another person who is bereaved. When there's when you have good tidings, for instance, a teacher has retired, for instance, there's a teacher going to wed, it's a communal affair. So we all work as a team. Unity has really grown. It is not where it was or how it was in the past. And I hope it will continue, because that's what the principal encourages us to do.
I want to thank the principal, Mr. Mutiso, who has played a key role, has been a father figure, you know, bringing the teachers together, something which never used to happen, because most cases, or the previous years, you would find that most of these teachers would just act or do things, you know, at individual level without considering that unity. But right now there's unity of purpose, so I want to thank the principal for that, bringing all of us together, you know, seeing things from the same perspective, which is very, very good. And something else about the principal is that he encourages us actually, and also gives us that the platform for all the teachers to showcase their abilities, you know, and you know, now that the teachers have been given that freedom, you know, to practice what they were trained to do, this one actually has encouraged them, motivated them, and I can see that most teachers actually go to an extra mile trying to help the students.
I think we have attained such cohesion that we rarely think ourselves as male or female or Muslim or Christian. We are all just teachers of Shimo la Tewa, and that makes me very happy.
Mr. Mutiso has also gone beyond the call of duty to ensure that no student drops out of school or misses exams. Many a time, he has used his own resources to help needy students. In January 2019, Kenyans were moved by the plight of Samuel Okengo, a Form 1 boy who had traveled alone from Kisii to seek admission at Shimo la Tewa School, even though he had no school fees. Thanks to Mr. Mutiso's plea to the public, Samuel received help from well-wishers who included Kotu boss Mr. Francis Atuodi. Indeed, the help was so much that part of it is now being used to educate Samuel's brother, who was subsequently also enrolled at Shimo la Tewa. Today, Samuel is in Form 3 and his dream to become an engineer is still very much on course. His brother Evans is in Form 2 and wants to be a doctor. Another recent example is that of Fabian Mwikali, a Form 2 student who dropped out of school in February 2021 due to lack of school fees. Thanks to efforts by the BOM chairman and the principal, Fabian received full sponsorship for his secondary education. Mr. Mutiso's positive influence extends even to other schools. He was very instrumental in the plan to relocate Mamangina Girls High School from Ganjoni to Shanzu.
The Mamangina Girls have been very close friends. Realize that this school is very small. In fact, it is on a less than an acre piece of land. And it is a national school, boarding, the only one in Mombasa. So there has been a lot of congestion and there was that need for relocation. So when the government looked around and the leaders in the region looked around, they realized that Shimo la Tewa would be the best option because they had over 100 acres of land. So when Shimo la Tewa was approached, they agreed and gave Mamangina 10 acres of land. A meeting was called between the two boards in Nairobi. And while in that meeting, they again accepted to add us 10 more acres. So now Shimo la Tewa has given us 20 acres. And the prison department has given us 10. So in total, that is 30 acres. Yeah. And we are very grateful for that. We cannot take it for granted.
Mr. Mutiso's efforts in improving the standards of education at the coast have not gone unnoticed. In 2020, he won the Regional Principal of the Year Award. Subsequently, the Teacher Service Commission promoted him to the prestigious position of Chief Principal in 2021. The media has also observed that owing to the focused and steadfast leadership of its current principal, the mighty Shimo has roared back to life. Despite his prestigious position and remarkable achievements, Mr. Mutiso cuts the image of a servant leader who is loved and appreciated by those around him.
There are several distinct characteristics about him. And the first one is his humility. His humility comes out very strongly. And in sometimes people may think he's stupid, rather naive. There was a time he came at home laughing. And when I asked him, nini nakuchekesha, he told me there were some officers who wanted him to take them where. When he told them, it's in a guy, all of them were shocked. it really impressed them. How can this man be in such a school and not possess a vehicle? I'm usually humble when we go to church, because when we come out, we all climb a matatu and go to maybe Naivas or to Nyali, wherever we're going, usually use a matatu or a tuk-tuk. When you're there, the conductor of the song comes in. You're just there when your mazo na shanga, ujama. And then he just moves. So his humility is very, you know, key. And I think it just made him who he is. The other characteristics which I like to mention about him is his faith in God. From when we were young, he used to say, Collins, Siri, sikilizeni chenye nawaambia. Mi hakuna kitu yenye nafanya bila Mungu. And everything he does, when we wake up in the morning, we have to pray. When we go to sleep, we have to pray. When he goes for a journey, we have to pray. I know even when the school opens, he has to pray. When there's a meeting, he has to pray. He puts God first in everything he does. And I think because of that character, God has enabled him to rise. He is also a well-prepared man. What's the term? He prepares well for his duties. When he comes at home, no matter how tired he is, you'll see him ironing for the next day, ironing the clothes for the next day. And he also brushes his shoes before he goes to sleep. And he's a very hardworking man. There's nothing which gives him joy than seeing a student, a former student, come to him and telling him, you know, Malim used to be my principal. Now I work in this area and I own this thing. It really gives him joy. And he's also hurt when he sees a student who taught not being successful in life. To also add on his characteristics is integrity. He's a very honest person. I remember in one of the schools, I won't mention the name, was having problems with the students because the previous regime had gotten used to showing the students the, you know, leakage. But him, when he went there, he didn't like that. He's more focused on academic integrity. They used to, you know, really struggle with the students because they thought he would show them, then he refuses. It used to be a big fight. But his redemption came when Matiangi decided to, you know, curb the malpractices in the exam. And that year, when 95% of the secondary schools dropped their marks, it happened that his school was among the few which improved by over 1 point. So that's how he got his promotion, Shimo la Tewa. The lowest moments of his career, Shimo la Tewa, was when the school lost Madam Ross and Mr. Midamu. The two of them were senior teachers at the school. And you could see the grief in him. The highest moments, I cannot exactly pinpoint one. I remember there was a time the CS Mina came, planted a tree, and it was shown on TV. He was very happy, sent us all pictures. And there was also the moment when the student from DC was featured on TV. He was also very happy. The happiest he was when he received the results of 2020 class, Shimo la Tewa. I think he was very happy when he got 7 years.
Mtiso ni mzee wa kanisa, katika kanisa hili. Tangu natoke mali alikuwa kakuja huku, na nilikuwa na mfahamu. Nilipokuja tukamuuliza. Kwanza kabla ya mtu alikuwa tunamuuliza kama anakubali. Na hakukuwa na shaka, hakukataa kukubali kuchukua uongozi. Ukiangalia vyombo hizi za kupaza sauti, ni mmoja ambaye amestia spearhead juzi kununua vyombo tena upya. Kwa hiyo mzee amekuwa wa baraka na muhimu sana. Mtiso sio mtu unamapproach kwa kitu hata kuambia kwa haraka ndio ama hapana. Na kwamba acha nifikirie. Sio mtu wa kufanya maamuzi haraka kwa kukataa na kukubali, na ni mpaka achukue muda aelewe jambo ndio ajibu ama alitende.
Actually, if there is anybody I would praise on earth, it is the chief principal, Mr. Marcus Mbinda. Because for one, he is not just a mere a principal. He is a leader. He is a counselor. He is an elder. I would use all terms possible to think of to describe what kind of man he is. Because actually, a mentorship program, he is a mentor. Yeah. All the teachers, as we talk to him, as I talked to him some time back, he told me that he very much interested in having all teachers becoming principals. So maybe it's under that prayer of his that made me become a principal too soon. I never took three months in this school, then I became a principal. So I believe other teachers are also coming, those who are working under him. He's encouraging, when there is a small issue, he picks it up very fast. He doesn't let it go big. And I believe if principals will behave like that, then schools will be very okay.
Principal is supportive. He is a good boss. He's a boss that you can approach. You can talk to him about anything and everything. Both on a personal basis and on a work basis, I've found a lot of help from him. And even my colleagues would tell the same, because he has this listening ear. And also, he's also a problem solver. You take something to him and you can discuss it. And at the end of it, you have a solution. And above all, because he listens, if you go with an idea, he's a person who will give you an opportunity to try.
Huyu mwalimu wetu ni mtu ambaye ana upendo kwa wafanyikazi mwalimu, na hivi yote ni mtu wa bidii zaidi, ni mnyenyekevu na mwalimu ambaye hawezi fananishwa na walimu wakuu wengine, kwa kuwa amekuwa msaada mkubwa zaidi katika shule hii, upande wa wanafunzi, upande wa walimu na upande wa wafanyikazi wote. Habagui, haweki viwango, na zaidi ya yote ni mpenda Mungu.
I believe Mr. Mutiso, he serves a state award for his outstanding contribution in the educational sector. He's our shujaa.
Ebwana, waswahili walisema chanda chema kuviko pete. Ama kwa kweli, walimu wetu mkuu Bwana Mutiso Mbinda anastahili kutuzwa, kushukuriwa, kuzawadiwa na pia kupongezwa kwa kazi njema aliyoifanya. Kutoka katika shule upili ya Shimo la Tewa, mimi ni Harrison Mabakuni.
As the bell rings, signaling the end of one lesson and the beginning of another, it perhaps also symbolically announces the beginning of a new period of academic excellence and prosperity at Shimo la Tewa School.
This school is going far. That one I can say. Yeah.
The next 5 to 10 years, my dream is that Shimo la Tewa will be a very great school compared to now. Even though now it is good, but it will be better.
We tunaweza badilisha. Ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, tunaweza badilisha. Ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, tunaweza badilisha. Ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, tunaweza badilisha. Ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, tunaweza badilisha. Ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, tunaweza badilisha. Ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, tunaweza badilisha. Ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, tunaweza badilisha. Ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, tunaweza badilisha. Ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, tunaweza badilisha. Ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, ni mimi tuna wewe, tunaweza badilisha.